Boy Scouts are now letting transgenders in. There was a lawsuit. They avoid it by doing this, and it started in Sea Caucus, New Jersey, with today's birthday, 9-year-old Joe Maldonado. And when this all happened, I called my friend Julia Scotti, who was quite upset and wrote a scathing article that you could read at nj1015.com. And now, not only does America Got Talent, but Julia's got new hips, and we bring her on, Julia Scotti!
Hey, what's happening?
How about it? How you see that? When you get mad, things happen, lady. Look at this.
Boy, I'll tell you. I'm really happy. It happened a lot quicker than I thought. I didn't know about the lawsuit, so I assumed something, it just became cheaper to just say, okay.
I think that's what they did. You know, I think that's like, because it, not only that, it's good for business. It lets more people come in. It what's the word I'm looking for? Contemporarizes the Boy Scouts?
Well, I think, back when I came out 14 years ago, I mean, nobody was out. So, I mean, I was, alone in the wilderness. But as, time has passed and social media and, media in general picking up on these stories, more and more people are coming out, and they're coming out earlier. And I think that's wonderful. You know, something becomes less strange when you have more and more of that particular type of person,
Well, let me ask you this, because we're getting this a lot, too. At 8 years old, do you really know if you're transgendered, or could this be a phase? Or is it? I don't think it's any of the Boy Scouts' business, actually. Just you have to accept what they say.
Yeah, I heard your last call. Well, let me ask you this question. At 8 years old, did you know you were a boy?
Well, I kind of had a lot of proof.
Well, the proof is not, that's not the issue. It's never about genitalia. It's about the things that, you liked as a boy. You just naturally were a boy.
Yeah, but that's the thing. Like, my son's 10 years old, Julia. They're playing football with girls, and the girls are having a blast. I mean, at that age, everybody, I say it's just call them scouts, because especially today, with, like, the stereotypes being removed, girls are not just playing with dolls, you know what I mean? Everybody's right. Playing with everything. So, again, I ask. Oh, I mean, again, I asked, do you really know? I mean, like, could she really know that she's a he, or at this phase of her life, just liking boy stuff? And if she starts developing, that'll go away.
Yeah, I mean, it may happen. I don't think it will. Somebody that young is declaring at that age, and it's been constant. If a kid's going to lose interest, they're going to lose interest after a week or two, maybe.
Right.
But this kid, it's been a year now. He's living as a boy. School's treating him like a boy. He seems very happy as a boy. Even if it is a phase, where's the harm? Let him be who he is.
That's a good point.
Who's it hurting,
That's the whole point of it. Who is it hurting? What difference does it make? Your article was great, especially when you talked about, the Boy Scout oath. On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to God and my country and obey the Scout law, to help other people at all times, to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight.
Yeah, and I also mentioned in there that it took them 60 years to integrate the Boy Scouts.
How about that? Yeah. We got to talk. I saw the Italian-Americans today. And when you talk about what our people went through, oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh my God. But that's another topic.
Biggest mass lynching in the country's history.
Yeah, in New Orleans in 1891, Italians.
Yep.
But now, I got to ask you, were you a Boy Scout?
I was.
In your previous life?
Our Lady of Grace Church. In Fairview, New Jersey. Yep.
All right. So, like, I know you help other people at all times, but the physically strong, mentally awake part, I've always questioned. I'm morally straight. Yeah, I won't even touch.
I was not what you call a great scout. I didn't. I don't know. Again, but even back then, I felt something was not right.
Amiss.
And I was much more attracted to the Girl Scout uniform. that my sister had, and I was like, oh, I can't leave stuff. And then I got the snot beat out of me, one night at church. I mean, we were at a Boy Scout meeting, and our Scoutmaster decided we should all learn to box.
They put me in this.
I was like 12. They put me in the ring with this 16-year-old kid. He just beat the living hell out of me. So that kind of turned me off to the, you know, to the scouting after that. That needing out of 10 cups.
All right, that, right.